A hearing at the U.S. Capitol on the attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi, Libya. Republican lawmakers have blasted the Obama administration over its handling of security and safety of the diplomats and staff at the mission. They've been demanding answers for months and are getting the chance to grill State Department officials about who knew what and when. World Affairs reporter Elise Labatt joins us now live from Washington. This is such a complicated web of questions that are being raised, but clearly Republicans and others don't feel they know the whole truth about what happened before, during, or after.
John, that's right. I mean, even though so much has been done, so many hearings, so much testimony, you had the independent accountability review board report, but still, particularly Republicans having a lot of questions as to not only what the State Department did or did not do to protect diplomats leading up to the September 11th attack, how they handled it that night, and also questions about how the administration handled what happened, whether it was a protest or whether it was a terrorism attack. Greg Hicks, the deputy of Ambassador Chris Stevens, who was killed in the attack, gave a very riveting account of how he was notified about what was going on. Let's take a listen.
At about 3 a.m., I received a call from the Prime Minister of Libya. I think it's the saddest phone call I've ever had in my life. He told me that Ambassador Stevens had passed away. I immediately telephoned Washington that news afterwards.
And John, there was a lot of other things that Greg Hicks said. He told investigators that he felt he was not able to talk to congressional investigators. He felt intimidated by the State Department. And he had a lot of questions as to why a special forces team was not sent from Tripoli to Benghazi to help out those diplomats, those officers under attack, and a lot of other things about what he said about how he felt this could have been prevented, John.
Now, there was an enormous absence from the hearing room today, and that is Hillary Clinton, who was Secretary of State at the time. It would seem that this is very much about her for reasons both personal and political. Where is she in all of this?
Well, she was not even interviewed by this accountability review board. This independent board said that these decisions were not made at her level, but what Greg Hicks, what others were saying, other people testifying today, particularly Mark Thompson of the Bureau of Counterterrorism, was that Secretary Clinton did bear some responsibility, that they felt that this accountability review board kind of let some people off the hook. They said that Secretary Clinton, you know, ultimately is responsible for security in the department. And as you know, in an interview with CNN, she did take responsibility back in October. But basically, I think a lot of people think this is a political attempt to go after Secretary Clinton. There's a lot of speculation that she may run for president in 2016. And this is an effort to clip her wings. At least that's what the Democrats say.